In my previous videos, I had solved some problems like how to sketch a signal, like when there was addition of step functions or the ramp functions. But here you can see that there is a step function also, there are ramp functions also. In this case, now how we are going to sketch this signal? Okay, so first you consider x of t that is equal to u of minus t plus 2 plus r of t plus 1 minus r of t minus 1. So u of minus t plus 2, this is of the form u of minus t plus or minus t naught, where I had explained you when I was discussing about the step function that this function, it starts from minus infinity and it ends at t naught. That means if you have minus t plus 2, yeah, that means it starts at minus infinity and it ends at 2. If you have u of minus t minus 3, then it will start from minus infinity and it will end at minus 3. So now u of minus t plus 2, it starts from minus infinity and it ends at 2. This is your u of minus t plus 2. Then what is r of t plus 1? This is nothing but the advanced version of your ramp function. So from this you can see it is t plus t naught. That means it will start at a point where t plus t naught is equal to 0. T is equal to minus t naught. Okay. So it will start from minus 1. Since this is a ramp function, it's not a unit step function. This is a ramp function. So it goes like this. Right, this is your r of t plus 1. Now this is having a slope 1, coefficient is plus 1, so this is your increasing ramp. So when I consider minus r of t minus 1, r of t minus 1 is nothing but it is the delayed function. Okay, it is the delayed ramp function, but it is having a slope minus 1. That means you are going to do the amplitude reversal here, right? You are having r of t minus 1 like this. But what if I multiply the amplitude by minus 1? You are going to get that in the reverse direction. Okay. So, slope is minus 1. So, from 1, you have like this. This is your minus r of t minus 1. This is your r of t plus 1. This is u of minus t plus 2. Now, we have to add all these three signals. So this one I will consider as x1t, this one I will consider as x2t, and this one I will consider as x3t. Okay, see, from the till interval minus 1, okay, that is from minus infinity till 1, okay, we have only x1t, we have only x1t. And from minus 1 to 1, from minus 1 to 1, we have both x1t and x2t. We have both these signals. Next, from 1 to 2. 1 to 2. Why I am taking 2? Because your first signal is ending at 2. So after 2, you will not have any effect from the first signal, that is x1t. So till 2, you will have all the signals because this is also starting from 1, right? x3t. So you will have all the signals x1t, x2t, and x3t. But what will happen when it is greater than 2? When t is greater than 2, you will not have the first signal, but you will be having both the signals x2t and x3t. So in this case, it will be x2t and x3t. So your x of t, that will be equal to x2t plus x3t in this case. And here in this case, it will be x of t is equal to x1t plus x2t plus x3t. So let us sketch the signal x of t. Now, first I will take this interval. First interval, minus infinity to 1. So minus infinity to minus 1. It is minus 1. Okay. Your only first signal. Okay. So it will be your constant signal which is having the step height of 1. Okay. So let me take this as 1 now. So it is having a step height of 1. Step function I am keeping as it is. Now from minus 1 to 1, now you got an increasing ramp. That is a ramp with a positive slope. So when you are adding a constant with your increasing ramp, obviously you will get an increasing ramp itself. but it will be shifted upwards. That is, there will be a vertical shift. Because you know, if I consider this as sine t, okay, if I am increasing it, like if I am adding it with 1 plus sine t, that means you are going to have the vertical shift, right? So if this is 1, so I will consider like this, means it will be shifted vertically, okay. Likewise, this 1 plus r of t plus 1, that means it will be shifted 1 unit upwards, okay. This will be shifted 1 unit upwards, that is still 1. Let me consider like this. So, in place of minus 1, I will have 1. So, in place of 0, we had 1. But here, see, you are having 2. In place of 1, we had 2 here. But here, 1 plus 2, that becomes 3. Right? This is your 3. Now, what happens? So, this will be continuing now. That will be the increasing ramp. But from 1, you are having the effect of third signal. That is still 2, it will be there. Because till 2 only we have this step. Okay. So, till 1 to 2 we will consider. 1 to 2 we will consider. So, there is an increasing 1. But now, you are getting the decreasing 1. So, it should produce a constant signal. Right? Positive slope and a negative slope. If you are going to add these two, you are going to get a constant signal. Okay. That is here. Here you are going to get the constant signal. So the similarly here, okay, this is an increasing and with shifted 1, but you are getting a negative ramp, that is the ramp with the negative slope. In that case, it will produce a constant signal. Okay, see here, at 1 you have 3, okay, at 1 you have 3, here you have 0. That means till 2 it will be producing a constant signal of constant signal of 3. But after 2, you will not have the effect of your unit step function. You will not have effect of unit step function. So, what happens? There will be decrease in the height now. It becomes till 2 because there is a decrease in the step height, right? So, from 1, it is going to 0. That means minus 1. So, it should come downwards. It was shifted upwards by 1 unit. Now, if you are not having this and there is a step change minus 1. Okay, minus 1. That means the signal, whatever it is proceeding, it should be shifted by minus 1 unit. Okay, because there is a change in your height. So, from 1 to 0. So, now it should come downwards. And it will continue. Why it will continue? Because though we do not have the effect of this signal now, but we have these two signals. Now this is having your positive slope. This is having a negative slope. So these two will be producing a constant signal. That is, it will be going like this. But why have we taken this? Because there is a step change, that is from 1 to 0. That means it should come down. It had gone here. This ramp, it shifted here. Why? Because of this effect, right? Step height. So that ramp should come down. Obviously, it should come down, right? So that is when it changes its height. So this is the answer. This is your x of t. Okay, this is your x of t. So just by saying that, we will try to plot it. Okay, so first I will consider these two, okay, r of t plus 1 and r of t minus 1. See, r of t plus 1 is nothing but it is starting from minus 1. Till your next change, I will consider this positive slope. But here at 1, there is a change in the slope. So 1 minus 1. Now I can add these two, right? So 1 minus 1, it is giving you 0. That means, now, whatever you are going to get, it should have a slope that is equal to 0. When will you get a slope that is equal to 0? When you are having this horizontal line, right? So, it will be like this. But, take this effect now. u of minus t plus 2. So this is still 2. Okay, now we will be adding these two signals. Okay, so here till 2, it will be from 2 to infinity, that will be same thing. But here, there will be shift. So instead of this, now it will be here. And here, instead of this, I will consider this point. Instead of this, I will consider this point. Okay, so we'll draw a straight line. So this one will be your signal. There is a step height change, right? Okay, so here it is 1. This is 2 and this is 3. So this is also 2. This is the signal x of t. So another is like, see, from minus infinity till 2, we have this signal, okay? So, till 2, that is here. But here what happens? So, just consider, I'll plot like this. Till minus 1, we will consider this step height. But that will be having a slope 0. This is having a slope 0. Now, this is having a slope 1. That means, till 1, you are going to get increasing 1. Right? Increasing ramp. Because slope 1. But at 1, your slope is going to change. So 1 minus 1, that is equal to 0. So the slope that will be producing the horizontal line. But it will not continue like this. It will not continue like this. Why? Because the effect of the first one, I have drawn here till this one, this point. So till this, it will be horizontal line like this. Okay. Then what happens? It comes down and then it continues, because there is a shift here. It was 1, here it will be minus 1, decrease in the height. So this form is similar to this. So let us try to plot the second one. So I will not use the lengthy procedure. Just by seeing this, let us solve this now. So y of t is equal to 3 of u t plus 3 minus r of t plus 2 plus 2 r of t minus 2 u of t minus 2 minus r t minus 3 minus 2 u t minus 4. Okay, in this case, see, it is starting from minus 3. I will plot all the numbers first. Okay. So let us consider like this. This is our signal y of t. See, at t is equal to minus 3, you have a step. Okay, you have a step. That is till t is equal to minus 2. So, let us consider this as 3, this as 2 and this as 1. Okay, so here we have a step of 3. That is till 2. Okay, I will consider this one now. At t plus 2, that is at t is equal to minus 2. Now the slope, this has a slope 0. Now it is changing. That is, it is getting the slope minus 1. That is till this point t is equal to 0. Till t is equal to 0, you are going to get a ramp with the negative slope. So at 2, you are having 3. That means at minus 1, it should be 2. At 0, it should be 1. So, that is a straight line here. Okay. This is 2 and this is 3. So, this is a ramp with the slope minus 1. That is till t is equal to 0. Now, at t is equal to 0, you are going to see the change again in the slope. So, here the slope is minus 1. Here the slope is plus 2. So, what is your change in the slope now? Minus 1 plus 2, that is equal to 1. So, again you are going to get a ramp, the resultant ramp with the slope minus 1 plus 2. See here, 0 minus 1, it's the ramp here. Minus 1 plus 2, it will be the ramp here. That is till t minus 2 is equal to 0, that is t is equal to 2. Till here, you are going to get the increasing ramp. Okay, at this point you have 3. And at 1 you have 2. Okay. So this is your ramp. That is still this point. Now here, see at minus 2, u of t minus 2, there it is telling minus 2 coefficient. So this is nothing but the step. Now we were considering the slope. So there is no change in the slope. See here, but what happens? There is a change in the step. So what happens? It is minus 2 means it should come 2 downwards, right? 2 downwards. And then this slope again continues. The slope is now, it is equal to 1 only. But you have a step here. So it should come down. Then see, at t is equal to 3, your slope is changing. Okay. So here you are having a slope. So that will continue now. Okay. That will continue again. There is no change in the slope, but just there was a step difference. So, but 3 now, you are getting a slope minus 1. So, this is having a slope 1. This is having slope minus 1. That means your resultant will be having slope 0. Slope 0 means you should get a horizontal line. Till where? Till t is equal to 4, you are going to get a horizontal line. Now, see, again there is a step difference now. Okay, there is not, this is not a slope now. Consider minus 2. Minus 2. So, minus 2 is your step height. That means again I should come 2 step downwards. So, 2 minus 2 will be equal to 0. Okay. Then onwards you will not have anything. So, this is done. You are not having a ramp again like this. Why? Because you already got the resultant slope that is equal to 0. I will tell you once again. See, this is your step 3 of u of t plus 3. That is your step. That step height is 3. That will continue because your ramp starts at t is equal to minus 2. So, till that you will be having a step. So, now the effect of slope starts. See, it is having a negative slope. Okay, negative slope, that is at t is equal to minus 2. This was having slope 0. So, 0 minus 1, that is minus 1. So, the slope is now equal to minus 1. That means you should draw a ramp with a negative slope. So, I have drawn this negative slope. And then comes 2r of t. So, this negative ramp, it continues till t is equal to 0. So, at t is equal to 0, your slope is changing. So, the previous slope was minus 1. The new slope is like getting added here, that is 2. So, resultant will be equal to 1. So, you are writing a slope now here, which is having slope equal to 1. Here, it is continuing. Okay, it is continuing. But what happens? There is a shift here. There is a shift in the step. That is by minus 2 units. So, this is going here, but it will come down and it starts to continue. It starts to continue. So, it comes by 2 steps downwards. It continues. But till where? See, you have another ramp at t is equal to 3. Okay, that means it is continuing, but it got an effect now, that is of the negative slope. So, that means it is producing a constant signal. So, that is, see, I have drawn a horizontal line. But after that, it is producing constant signal, right? But now, that is at 2. But now what happens? You are going to add with the step minus 2. 2 minus 2, that will be equal to 0. Okay? So, this is the way to understand. But just without drawing this, I had plotted this. This is actually the mechanism that is going inside here. Okay? That is, you are going to get a ramp here. But there is a shift in the step. So, it comes down and then it continues. Then you get a slope with a negative, okay, negative slope ramp. Here you have a positive, you know when positive and when negative slope is there, you are going to get a constant signal. So now constant signal starts from this point, it continues, but what happens at t is equal to 4, again you have minus 2 constant. That is from t4 you are having like this, right? So minus 2 plus 2. When it is added, it is going to give you 0. So, that means it is going to continue here. So, that is 0. Okay. This is what. Just, we will be seeing the slopes. So, step is 3. then at t is equal to minus 2 you are going to get a negative ramp. From that point onwards you write a negative ramp, then add the slope with the next one, so that is plus 1, so it is here. Then there is a change in the step, u of t minus 2 is not ramp, so there is a change in the step, so come downwards and continue till you get a negative ramp or another ramp. Okay, just till you encounter this, continue the ramp. Okay, though there is a step change, continue your ramp, because this one will be continuing but with a step difference. So here you will be having r of t minus 3, so this was having, the resultant was 1, now minus 1, so it becomes 0. The horizontal line will be having a slope 0. Okay, but here at this point you will be having step difference of minus 2, and then it will be continuing, because 1 minus 1, it is already giving you 0 slope. Okay, so here once again there will be no ramp. Okay, so this is the method to solve the x of t or y of t, that is, which is having the combination of unit step function or the ramp functions.